And here are some of the political reactions to the High Court decision.
High Court card.
The question we are asking tonight is, will a ban on caste-based rallies dent identity politics? To discuss that, I am joined by GVL Narasimha Rao, BJP leader, Vinod Kumar Sharma, political editor, Hindustan Times, and Manan Kumar Mishra, he is chairman, Bar Council of India. Welcome you all to Newsnight. Let me begin with you, Mr. Sharma. Will this decision of the High Court diminish identity politics in UP?
I don't think so. I am reminded of what
Gandhiji said. He talked about the change of heart. This system of caste, which is as old as the hills, as old as our civilization, is there. And this has been practiced in myriad ways by political parties, by individuals. May I ask those political parties which are pretending to welcome this decision, that don't they appoint a system? Now, we have to change that way of life in order to get a better way of life. No court judgment can address the issue of identity politics.
So you are saying the Supreme Court should settle this issue. I'll take your opinion on this.
They should ban.
So if political parties hold caste-based rallies in any part of the state, then that is violative of the Constitution. Is that what you are suggesting? That is violative.
That is violative of the Constitution.
Yeah. You completely disagree with him, but let me bring in
One point before you go to Narasimha. And I think he'll have his own take on this. You see, the First Amendment to the Constitution of India was for providing
other than the assembly politics.
No, please. If Mayawati is calling, for instance, a rally of Brahmins, I think she's expanding and becoming more inclusive in her approach. That she is now calling a rally of Brahmins. Or is calling a rally of other backward castes.
Does that make a divisive
Is this a movement towards inclusive politics, or is it a movement towards exclusive politics?
Right, Mr. Sharma. Let me, including the BJP, which are representing on the panel tonight, have welcomed the order. Do you think this order will now force political parties to fight elections purely on bread and butter issues, Bijli Sarak Pani, development, growth?
You see, caste voting is a particular caste, or a public mobilization of a particular caste for electoral purposes. To my mind, I think it's a welcome step. Caste has been an important factor in Indian elections for many, many years. But of late, particularly in states like UP, as much as in other states, because we tend to overstate the case of UP and Bihar. But let me also say, caste is a very big factor across the country, in all states in the country, almost all states in the country. In fact, caste is something that has helped people to sort of, that is used by people as to make some kind of long-term choices. Good or bad, court is saying
what
is no public display, no public mobilization. I think it's a welcome order. I think it's a welcome
decision. Candidates are political parties for elections and caste.
Please come again.
What do caste-based political rallies do which selection by political parties of candidates for elections don't? Isn't the underlying principle the same?
What is happening? That's what I'm saying. There are certain things which happen by way of the private choices that people make. And there is something that, and it becomes a very important factor in selection of candidates. Nobody can dispute that. And the court cannot decide
both
direct
sides,
and
Mr.
more
Rao.
And more murkier.
You are arguing from both sides, no, Mr. Rao. It seems you are adopting a cautious
approach. That's what I'm saying. So caste, you cannot take caste away from elections. Caste will continue to remain a fact of life. Let us accept that. But at the same time, what the court has said is equally, I think it's very, very welcome, because you cannot make it a public, you cannot seek votes publicly in the name of caste and religion, which is what people in the country have been doing. I think what court has said extends to religion, seeking religious or congregations as well. It's not just the caste. So I hope it will be seen in a broader perspective.
Right. Mr. Sharma, do you think this will be a game changer in UP politics?
No, I don't think. Let's understand this. You know, societies don't get reformed. There isn't any paradigm shift of the thinking of the common people. Courts are, you know, assuming for themselves a role which is beyond them. This has to be achieved. I've known n number of people who have moved from the countryside into big cities. And because they see so much of success, they see so much of money being earned by their peers at their places of work, that gradually, though at a very slow and glacial pace, their identity consciousness is being replaced by their aspirations. So the answer to this is education. The answer to this is change of mindsets. The answer to this is change of hearts. Say, for instance, this court almost, the court judgment almost means that if, that you know, you have to pay for whatever money you spend and you have to account for it before the election commission. What are political parties doing? If they have to address people of a particular you know, village or a particular small town, they make their you know, supporters, hardcore supporters, organize pangas, organize khanas, you know. You see, you are approaching the wrong end of the problem. If you really want to change the society, then come with a law that there shall be no intra-caste marriages, let there be only inter-caste marriages. Let's stop using our surnames, which are symptomatic of our caste, or which you know, which show our caste. But the point is that some learned judges, in their wisdom, have sat and given this judgment. And I think, with all humility, I mean, I have no right to, you know, sort of reality. This is a cosine, they are prescribed cosine for a cancer, for cure of a cancer. You know, you can't do that. I mean, this is something which can only be cured through a social chemotherapy.
Mm-hmm. I'll take the last word from Jeevan Narasimha Rao. Where do you think the root of the problem lies? Do you concede that hasn't been for the past so many decades?
Yes, for any society, I think caste-based voting is not at all a healthy trend, because people should be voting. Ideally, people should be voting on the basis of ideology or on the basis of manifestos or performance. But then, at least,
do you regret the fact that the trend and casteism has taken deeper roots in our political establishment? Do you regret that trend?
Yes, certainly it's not healthy for democracy. It's not healthy, but then that's a reality. There is a difference between accepting the reality. So what the court has done today will certainly, I think, temper this kind of attempts to publicly and to in a very unabashed manner seeking out support for different caste-based groups.
The Lucknow bench of the Allahabad High Court set a precedent for the entire country, and will it really curb the growth of identity politics in our political establishment? Well, the jury is out on that one. We'll move on now. A juvenile justice board that conducted the trial of an accused in the December 16 gang rape case has today deferred the verdict in that particular case. The police, remember, has claimed that standing outside support of the UPA was at the Prime Minister's residence for nearly half an hour and left just before the cabinet meeting was to begin. He rubbished talk of SP withdrawing support over the ordinance. Well, moving on now, here is a reaction from the Congress on this. Chat polls kicked off in three Naxal-infested districts of West Midnapore, Bankura and Purulia. Security